Gmail.com is now online.
Alright, here we go on the second game. We are on Neo Requiem. As you can see, actually, on the mini-map, they're pretty close to each other. We have Tempest at the 9 o'clock position, and we have Chedong at the 12 o'clock.
This is a very tense moment here.
I know.
For everybody at GOM TV, for all the Chedong fans, for all the Tempest fans.
Oh, wow. Man.
Wow.
You thought the first two were awesome.
Yeah,
oh,
yeah.
Man.
8% of the people out there actually thought the Tempest could win? Wow. All right, Jadon. He's turning it on right now. Whoop, there. See that blink there? That's when it's turned on. Look at those ghosty fingers. He's saving him for the end game. See how he had to move to the right side of the keyboard? More like in the middle. He has to do that because Protoss have to hover their hand over there. Terran and Zerg actually hover their hand more over the left side of the keyboard. Although in the late game, the Protoss end up hovering their hand over there as well. Fun fact. Now we're going to move the Overlord, unfortunately, in the wrong location. Jadon needs every chance he can get here. It's going to be a gate on 9.
Ooh.
Very aggressive, right at the bottom of the ramp, so that Zell can get there as fast as possible.
You want another fun fact? Speaking of the whole left side, right side, middle of the thing. You know, Hoja, who won the very first set, is left-handed.
Really?
Yeah.
Man, that always fascinates me, left-handed StarCraft players, because, you know, one thing that StarCraft players do is they talk so much about, okay, what do you hockey is what? What do you do is what? And you see left-handed players, I mean, they use the keyboard with a completely different hand, which
yeah.
means that they have to, it's totally different. I mean, everything.
fun fact.
Imagine doing 1A, 2A, 3A, wow, that should be, it's just so different to me. That's so interesting. Okay. Well, this is going to be a very, quick game, I believe, if I'm analyzing this correctly. All right, he's moving out with the Overlord.
He knows now that he's going the right way.
And, double hatch here. You can see, though, he's not going to attack, actually, until he finds where his opponent is. He's found it. Let's see if he moves the Zealot out now. Probably not, actually, if there's Ling's about to hatch here. He may just get the gas really, really fast here. Now, remember, we've seen a lot of drone drilling on this map. I don't know if we're going to see that again this time around. But two hatching like this and then getting a third there, upgrading early Ling's speed, it kind of, it's a technique that some Zergs use to kind of fake an economy game, and then they just go for this all-in drone drill. Now, bear in mind, though, Jadon's micro is rated a lot better than anybody else's in this tournament, which means if he does drone drill, it's going to be very powerful. Oh, probe not moving. I shudder when I see that. Okay, he's going to move out with the Zealots. I don't know if this is a good idea. And you can see, actually, he's not going to expand over there because he sees the Zealots now moving out. Or is he? I saw a drone over there earlier, but... Oh, he's going to glitch one. Oh, that's really smart. He's going to glitch one of the drones to the expansion back there where the Zealots can't harass. And then make a sunk in his main. That's baller. That's Gosu.
Wow.
That strat is just full of Gosu.
You know, here's a question for you. Are they allowed to do those things? Like glitch, drones and probes and...
Yeah, they actually are because it makes the game really, really interesting that you can get workers in some locations that... The rest of the units can't go. People debated about whether or not it should be illegal, but it actually just makes the game so interesting. Now, plus, it makes for some very interesting rushes on certain maps. Plus, if worker glitching would be illegal, think about it. They wouldn't be able to do this glitching that they're doing right now, where they're stacking the workers and effectively messing up attacking units. There's really no way to hold off rushes without it. So, takes out the probe. Nice, nice, nice. Four Lings slip into the main. He's just staying over there. He wants to see what's going on. Meanwhile, it looks like these Zealots are going to go in here. Oh, this could be a tense moment, actually. Uh-oh. Now he's going to go in here and just wipe out these Zealots. Wow, ownage. Pure Pwnage. Which is a great show, by the way.
I was just going to say that, actually.
It is. It's a great show.
You know,
I got to meet Jared in person. He is a really funny guy. He says he's going to come to Korea sometime. Jared, if you're watching this, come to Korea. You told me you'd be watching, Jared. There's going to be a quiz after this, Jared. 10 questions. Make sure you watch all the games. Okay, he's Michael for the Ling Bus there at the front. Probably not a good idea, though. There's too many units there. And he takes out the Yelings with no problem. Now, now's the moment where Jadong has to build up an economy or be aggressive. Wow, I guess he's going to be aggressive. I wonder if we're going to see some ridiculous drone drill here on this map. He might look and see, is my opponent going to get a Citadel, or does my opponent get the Stargate before he drone drills? Although, if he gets a Den, then we're immediately going to know that that's not going to happen. We don't see the layer up yet. Okay, it's going to be a Stargate. Following up with Hydra is quite strong in this situation. Zerg's really going to focus hard on not... Yeah, he's going to get the Den. He's in good shape so far. He's going to do, looks like Speed Hydra, as we don't see the layer up yet. I'm sorry, now the layer's up. I can't predict everything. All right.
Why not?
I know, I didn't bring my my Protoss crystal ball that tells me. It's my magic 8-ball, I shake it. Will he Ling Rush this game? Maybe.
Ask again later.
Ask again later. All right, he's going to try to slip over here. Nope. No luck here. Two groups of Lings. One's going to try to slip in and take out probes. He's got to be very careful. And here he goes. Edging forward with the Dragoon. He mushes over here. Deflected, though. Completely deflected. Oh, nice. Nice. Going to take out the Zealot. No problem there. Now he's going to rush in with the other ones, but does he have enough in his main to defend correctly? Requiem, such an interesting map. Look at that cross in the middle of the map. It's like Justice just had a concert here. Yeah, okay, he's moving in here now. He's edging in. He's going to go for the Den. The gateways are unpowered. He's got it. Well, it doesn't matter too much if he loses it. He can remake it, but it still might affect his Hydra upgrades. There may be too many units, though. Both players microing pretty hard here. Nice surround. Jadon's taking him out. He's taking him out. He's taking him to school. The gateways are gone. He can move into the main. We're probably going to go on to game three here with Jadon in the lead. Well, not in the lead. Tied. You know what I mean. It's exciting. Tempest's response is to immediately get a robotics bay. He's going to have to get a reaver out here. He probably can't get the gateways up in time. Oh, man, this is going to be impossible.
Look at those zerglings go.
Yeah, man, those zerglings are badass killers. He's going to take out the gateway, then move back in there and take out the forges. I mean, not the forges, the gateways right when they're warping in. One Hydra at home to defend. Oh, man, the Overlord's going to be picked off. Where'd that Hydra go?
Was that picked up? No. Oh, there he
there
is.
There he is.
He was hiding.
Get back to work, Hydra. Smart move here by Tempest. He's going to keep pumping Hydras.
Tempest is pumping Hydras. No.
No. He is pumping Corsairs. But what I was thinking of back there was the fact that Hydras are needed to defend that, so he can't be too aggressive here. Spire, though, coming up here at this expansion. Oh, my God, he's losing too many Overlords. This is exactly what Tempest needed to come back, and it's actually working. There's just too many. He can keep pumping Corsairs. Nice. Takes out another Overlord. You can see that he wants to get that Robo Bay, but he can't. The Reaver is going to be out pretty soon here. He has to keep these Overlords alive, because if he does it, there won't be enough Mutas out here to combat these Corsairs. How many has he lost? He could have made another hatchery right now.
I know.
With the number of Overlords that he's lost. And you can see now, Tempest is aware of this tremendous advantage he suddenly has. He's going to get a bunch of gateways, probably going to cut probes, going to try to do a timing move here and take out his opponent that way. Scourge, a little bit offset there.
Where are you going, Scourge? Target's over there.
He must be flying a little bit sideways. It's up to Jadong right now to defend with Scourge. Yes, that perfect Scourge control here. Scourge control. I'm trying to fix it, guys. I'm trying to fix it.
That's fine.
I have this Zerg speech impediment or whatever I have. Okay, he's got the Corsairs. He's got the Reaver. He's got the shuttle. Jadong has to have perfect Scourge control, which is going to be very difficult. Now, we know his control's good. Is it good enough? Looks like Tempest is going to expand. Get out of my face, Zergling.
He's making a... he's expanding.
Okay, he's not going to play entirely aggressively. He's going to try to expand, maybe get a few more Dragoons, I guess, and then do a push. He might have seen how many Scourge there were. Scourge! And then been like, all right, I need some Dragoons to snipe that stuff so my shuttle doesn't get picked off.
Oh.
You should have stayed at home, Corsair. There is so many things that can go wrong for you on this map. Oh. He can just go in there and snipe the Reaver. The Reaver.
It's done.
It's gone. Oh, man. That's what Jadong needed right there. He cannot expand now. Jadong's still in this. In fact, I would have to say that I think Tempest might be out of this now. Oh, man. Wow, where did the Corsairs go?
Jadong is showing us again how incredible his micro is. Look at that control, man.
His control is just so good. And unfortunately, now Protoss can't expand. Protoss has a bunch of... a bunch of tech buildings in his base, but nothing. Oh, man. What a hopeless death for a Dragoon. Stuck between a rock and a bunch of Zerglings. Oh, my God. He's going to get the Scourge again. Now he can just get the Reaver. See, this is exactly what Jadong needed to do, is just snipe the shuttle and Reaver. That he may even want to punch out GG here. Man. This sucks for Tempest. I've been in positions like this.
As a Protoss player, what can he do?
Pretty much nothing, actually. I don't think it's possible to win. You can see he's sending probes out now. He's trying to get the expansion. Do you think a Zergling Mutalisk is very strong against Dragoons, which is exactly what Tempest tech can do. And now Tempest can't keep a Reaver.
There's the GG.
Good game. GG. He's still in this. You can see he's focused right now. Jadong told me he was determined to win Season 2. Again. Tempest probably not feeling as happy as he was in that last game.
This is it. This is the make or break. Game 3. Have we seen the third map at all today? This is our third match that went on to set
3. Third match, yeah.
We are on Medusa then, making its debut performance today. Tell us a little bit about Medusa.
Medusa is a really technical map. It's a fast expanding map. You have this temple, which if you can, you can glitch workers up or other units up with the help of another probe or other worker. You can get up onto their high ground. You can also kill the temple. There's 4 or 5 of them stacked on top of each other. So it makes for some very interesting games.
All right, so here we go. Last set of the evening, last game of the evening, game 3 on Medusa. We have Jadong and Tempest. They are both now joined the game, and any
minute now, we're going to get this going. Don't worry, it'll start a little bit. I got to drink, I think I'm all out of water. I got a little bit left here.
No, actually, they just asked for 3 minutes.
3 minutes, okay.
So we have a 3-minute break before this game is going to start.
That's fine. Doesn't bother me at all. I can go get some more water. This cup's the water cup. This is the cup for I drink the tears of newbies I've slain on iCup. So but I gotta refill this one. Yeah. I'm brutal. We get a little break? Yeah, we are. Stay tuned.